Hey, welcome back. It's been a while. Happy New Year to everybody. Been super busy with a lot of other stuff, and I haven't really had a whole lot of time in the garage. Also, my garage is, there's not a lot left in here right now. It's kind of in the midst of being moved. We've had a crazy snowstorm here, so I've had a bit of time to put together the Dyno video electronics. To tell you some stuff that I did wrong, that I had to buy more stuff, stuff that worked, stuff that didn't. And we'll run up this very haggard Derbi variant, and we'll see what it puts out on this dyno. Now, because this is something I made, it probably needs a bit of calibration, but I'll show you that all the features work, what worked for me, what sensors to use, and yeah, we'll cover a little bit of that. First thing, let's start with the wheel roller sensor. So, as you can see there, that is my wheel roller sensor. There is nothing fancy about it. Currently, it is a piece of steel, electrical taped to the shaft, because I haven't drilled and tapped a Allen head screw into there yet. And that is a littelfuse sensor. I'll show it on the screen here now, just the one that I got from DigiKey. And this one works. So this is an inductance gear tooth style, which means that it will trigger whenever a ferrous material is put in front of the sensor. I tried a whole whack of AliExpress sensors and none of them worked consistently. Surprise, surprise. But this one's actually still pretty cheap. This is the one that Two Stroke Stuffing recommends. The company that makes them, I can't recall who it is at the moment, they're phasing it out. So it doesn't actually exist anymore. There might be some new old stock ones, but they're not producing that sensor anymore. So this one, however, works pretty well from what my couple of tests that I've ran on it. I got it at DigiKey. I've seen them at Mauser. Pretty much any electronic store should be able to get you one of these. It's a 3-wire with a 5-volt reference, and like I said, it's a gear tooth sensor. So I grabbed a whole bunch of these style from AliExpress, which use a little magnet, and I've just consistently inconsistent is a good way to put it. It would not trigger as soon as you could roll the thing and it would trigger, and as soon as there is any amount of speed or any ignition noise, basically the sensor would stop triggering, and I don't know why that is. I'm not a super electrical guru guy, but yeah, so this is one of the two that I tried. I tried two. There was an NPN and an NTN, I think. I can't recall, but irrelevant either way, doesn't work. So save your money, because one of these was like $20 and the other one was $20, and this thing was $40 Canadian, so just buy this one right from the start. The other thing for sensors, we'll go on to the ignition sensors. So when I first made this, I got all trick and fancy and I ordered one of these off of Amazon, inductive clamp. And I got really inconsistent results with it. Now, granted, this was the cheapest inductive clamp that I could find on Amazon. Sensing a pattern here with this stuff. It's a lot of cheap stuff. It's not working out for me. Normally it does, but in this project it didn't. This was like $30, kind of a disappointment. It would work. Same thing as the rear wheel sensor. Super erratic. And once I got the wheel sensor figured out, I couldn't get the thing to maintain an ignition RPM. So you'd be doing a run and the ignition would just drop, and then it would pick back up again, and it would drop and pick back up again. So my fix for that was doing a inductance loop. Really simple to do. You basically take a piece of solid core copper wire and wrap it around the spark plug lead, put 20 times, 15 times, whatever, and run that into the sensor on the ARDyno. Then moving over to
the ARDyno itself. I found this box on Thingiverse and printed it on my 3D printer. As you can see, we have the wheel sensor running into here. You have the ground signal 5-volt reference on that one. And then this is the ignition pickup, and it is just a signal and ground. Best results is you want to ground the clamp on the motor. I put a little alligator clip on mine, and I just basically run that and just run it to something on the motor. I don't have any of the other sensor hookups hooked up because I don't have any air temp sensors or any of that thing to log. And that's pretty much it. You can also see I reflective taped, aluminum taped the inside to try and keep the noise out of the main unit when it's running. And seems to work. I'm also running the external 5-volt power just because I found it was a bit more stable with consistent power. So now, moving on to ARDyno. The software is confusing as heck, but also straightforward at the same time. It is one of those things that the more you use it, the better you understand it, but at the same time, it is kind of difficult to maneuver at first. It's very clunky. So yeah, you have RPM of the main roller. This is the digital readout of that. This is the max of the roller. Over here, I have the RPM of the motor. That's really the only gauges that I'd need because that's all I currently have hooked up. You want to have it set to COM port only if you're using an Arduino. That said, if you are using audio for the TAC input, which you can do, but I have not done it, you basically can use the onboard mic as an RPM pickup, but again, I'm not doing that, so I'm not really too sure on the specifics on that. So we're COM port only, and then you have to pick your Arduino COM port from the drop down. Set your refresh rate. Mine is set different than most. I think on the stock sketch it's I think it's 9600 baud, but let me just crack this open over here. Let me just hide all this stuff for a second. So if I open, so if you want to know what your baud rate is within the sketch, you can check it if you open up your Arduino software, open recent, simple Dyno sketch, and it will tell you right there on that line, serial begin. So you can set that to any one of those, but they have to match or it's not going to work. That's pretty straightforward. Dyno is all the specifics of the Dyno that you roller that you've made. Vehicle mass is not critical. Any of this top stuff is simply not critical at all. It's this stuff, roller diameter, critical. The wall thickness, critical. As you can see here, it's still, you still have to put a wall thickness in there, even if your roller is solid, like in my case. The roller diameter, it says down here, you must put half the roller diameter as the wall thickness. And then your roller mass, your axle diameter, your axle mass, all stuff that you can figure out with the help of Google. And then there's extras, end cap max, extra wall thickness, signals per RPM, important. You need it to know how many pulses it makes per, you need it to know how many pulses it makes per ignition pickup or spark event. And then signals per RPM is, how many magnets or pickups you have for a toothed wheel. So if you had like a 30 tooth wheel, that means it would be 30 pulses for every rev. You'd have to put 30 in there. That's for your wheel on the dyno. And then the other one there is RPM 2, which is your ignition pickup. So if you have a wasted spark setup, for example, and on a single cylinder, you would put 2 in there because there'd be 2 spark events per every revolution of the motor. And that's pretty much that page, and that will get most of the nitty-gritty out of the way. So then basically the one you're going to want to do at that point is a power run. So let's quickly run through a power run here, and I'll show you what it shows on the screen. And a hint, this thing is pretty sad on the inside, but let's give it a go. So this is the initial screen that you see whenever you do a run. I'm not really sure what any of this is yet, but if you click analysis, it spits out your... This is the screen it spits out. Now this looks a bit wonky. Some of this is probably going to be because I didn't lock out the variator and didn't bring the wheel up to speed before I did the test. So I did the test full with the variator, so you're going to end up seeing weird wheel slip, but also points where the wheel speed starts increasing but the RPM doesn't. That probably skews the values that you're going to see on the dyno quite a bit. It tells me that this motor made a peak of 1.46 horsepower at the wheel. One other tip I'll show you though is this one here. So the extraction fan on this thing is just a piece of corrugated duct. And then it goes over to this box. Now I didn't make this box, this is I borrowed this from someone else, but you can make one pretty easily. All that's inside of that thing is a furnace fan. They're a squirrel cage blower, they run on 120 volts, so you can wire it up and plug it into the wall, and it moves a lot of air. Usually you can find them for free in old furnaces, which are pretty easy to come by. That's about as far as I got with this. It does functionally work, it needs some tuning, but this is probably one of my most requested follow-up videos, and I plan on following up on a bunch of other videos I've made as well and closing some of those out, projects and whatnot. I just need the time. However, I keep acquiring things like this, and there's some other stuff as well I acquired. But all that said, Dyno works. Like I said, I need to tweak it and play with it a little bit more. But you can get a functional number. Like, I've ran this thing 3 times now, and the horsepower has stayed about the same each time. So for a tuning aid, for something that you're just quite literally all you're going to do with it is just use it for comparative data. So, one run does this, one run does this, one run does this, you're changing stuff every time. It's a very useful tool in that sense. I don't really care about what the number it puts out is, I more care about what the change is between the numbers. So, however, I'm going to try and tweak it out a little bit more and get it running proper. And maybe try and understand some of these graphs, and if I do, I will let you know. But that's pretty much it for this evening. Until next time, take care.